many marvellous good things have I purchased not 2 days ago from Dulwich. First of all, have I got raisins and sultanas too, and apricots. Great wholesome sweetmeats are these, and a great perilous journey have they come, for the Spanish are making it the devil's own job to get these things into our septic isle unharmed. Also, have I dates from the Holy Land, and figs. I need not tell this lady about figs. A great and potent African disiac are they. Thou knowest how they are shaped. Also, have I got ginger from the Indies, garlic too. For do you keep a piece of garlic tied about thy neck, it will protect you from vampires, werewolves, wicked wights and witches. And do you keep it there a good long, it will protect you against everybody. And also, have I this great good curing thing which was sold to me by an apothecary out of Whitechapel. For do you chew upon a piece of this, for this is licorice root, you will be cured of your common cold, of your consumptive fever, your flat feet and your flatulence. A great good curing thing it is. Who will take a piece of licorice root of me?
I'll take one, peddler.
A wise fellow. That will be half a groat, thank you, sir. And may you fart no more.
Now music, dancing, as it is used these days, is an introduction to whoredom, a preparation to wantonness, a provocation to uncleanliness, and an introit to all kinds of lewdness. They say it induceth love, but what kind of love? A lustful love? A venerous love? A concupiscentious bawdy and bestial love, such as proceedeth from the stinking pump and loathsome sink of carnal affection and fleshly appetites. Therefore, 'tis to be wholly abandoned by all good Christians. Remember this, and go about the day in peace.
What do you mean, go about your day in peace, for goodness sake? I mean, you can go down your day with peace, but all I want is trouble all my whole life.
Do not listen to these heathens, they are charlatans. Be about your business, good people. Listen not to these men. They are devil worshippers and they offer sacrifice to Satanas.
Can you
be
see
about
the people
your way,
at
good
you
people?
Now. Be on your way yourself. Pardon. I just learned the other day how to juggle with me, sir. Juggle.
That's another one, sir. good mistress, do not tarry. This woman did keep me awake all night with a bad tooth and much moaning and perplexity.
Oh.
I will not have that again.
Oh, let me but once have a quick view of... Ah, jeez, you, yes, tis
rough. I see what you mean, sir.
Tis but a small matter, I shall draw it forth instant.
Have good much...
Now, mistress, do you be still, let us save your garments
thusly. So, now, do you hold her shoulders?
I have a firmly on my knee.
Mistress, this is the finest pincer.
I have good spirit.
Shall be butter.
Make it clean.
A swift matter.
Talk three, make it clean.
Wide as you may... Ow!
Oh,
wide as you may...
Okay, I'm going to charge me extra for that, man.
I have it. Now, let me draw firmly.
Give it a stop. Pull, man. Come on.
There you have it, ma'am, as clean a route as ever you could wish. And if you'll be so good, ma'am, in the bucket and not the street. And again, ma'am, if you'd be so kind. And there you have it. And a fair and sweet fourpence worth, sir, if you would be so kind.
Fourpence?
A mere fourpenny, sir, and so sweet a piece of workmanship at such a time. And none so high a price. Much obliged to you.
And good day.
Sir and mistress.
And I hope you will not complain at
night. You shall have much relief. Should there still be flame, my lord, do you pack the hole with just a little of tobacco?
Thank you, sir.
Rats caught, quick and clean. Rats caught.
Have you any bad teeth to draw?
There we are. That's fitting well on there. And then you've got the movement. And two lacing poles up here on the top.
Yeah, that's right.
Going somewhere?
Indeed I am, sir, about my business.
What is this? Oh!
A small matter of a sovereign owed.
I know you're not, gentlemen. How can I owe you a sovereign?
Hold, sinner. I cannot allow this naked blade abroad.
I think, Constable, this will permit it.
Who are you, gentlemen? I owe you no money.
But you do know Abraham of Whitechapel, and to him you owe the money.
And he shall be paid.
You are overdue by 1 week already. It's either the money or your ears.
I have no coin.
Then it must be your ears.
Lord Fitzwalter! My lord! My lord!
What is this, Bruit? Wherefore callst thou so loud?
These men will cut off my ears! This was money I spent in your service, my lord, please.
Well, I shall cover the debt. Here, gentlemen, unhand my servant.
Coming back.
Now, Simon, allow me to bend your one good ear.
Oh, oh, oh!
Commission. I think we can go spend some of it.
Thank you.
Come, come, come!
Enough, lads, enough! Bleed me. Go draw some out. Enough!
Constable!
Kill him!
Anybody.
Oh. Husband! Husband! Stay to the hag!
Away, young hag, away!
Don't chase her!
Maid, see to the broth.
Light-hearted view of life in Elizabethan England is based on an event organised by Nuns Meadow Productions. A small area of London's Alexandra Park was turned into a living village by constructing 8 individual houses and introducing a population of over 50 characters and professional performers. By careful research and attention to historic detail, an authentic, stimulating and entertaining atmosphere was created, which was able to transport thousands of Londoners 400 years back in time. Not all events need be on such a lavish scale. Nuns Meadow Productions can provide entertaining fairs, historical street scenes with booths, stalls, authentic characters, professional performers, and even portable houses which can be erected in many different settings, including stately homes, parks, courtyards, or as part of an indoor event or exhibition. Nuns Meadow Productions is able to provide a client with all types of period entertainers and has already been involved in many prestigious events throughout England.